Hello and welcome to another episode of the Daily Roundup. Today we discuss some of the most important stories that we report about here at NewsClick. Jharkhand was one of the first states that linked Aadhaar to the payment of wages under the Manrega Act in 2013. The government's initiative to check corruption and make welfare schemes transparent seems to have fallen flat, owing to fanatical reform and hurried implementation. A major reason for the failure of the Aadhaar linkage in Jharkhand, activists say, is the irregularities in services of the ICICI Bank and Fino Payments Bank. A large number of ICICI Bank accounts were opened by Fino Payments Bank in 2012 to 2013. Many of these workers already had bank accounts with Bank of India. In the last 2 years or so, all the ICICI Bank accounts were seeded with Aadhaar by the Fino Group and wages started being transferred to them, all without the workers' consent or knowledge. Even though this issue has been flagged several times by workers, local activists and media reports, the irregularities remain unsolved. Sabarimala pilgrimage came to an end for the season on December 27, and yet the Sabarimala issue remains as heated as ever in Kerala. On January 27, Dalit activist Ammini's family members were attacked by RSS activists in Sultan Batheri, Vayanad. The attackers manhandled her son, Prafulla Kumar, and forced him to chant Swamiye Saranamayappa. Ammini had attempted to enter the Sabarimala shrine on December 23, after the Supreme Court's judgement in favour of women's entry into the temple. However, she couldn't succeed in entering the temple as the protest led by Sabarimala Karma Samiti turned violent. In a similar case, noted Malayalam director Priyanandan was attacked by RSS activists in front of his residence on January 25. The National Film Award winner was attacked after his controversial Facebook post on Sabarimala. The director was beaten up and water mixed with cow dung was flung on him. Such attacks have become regular in Kerala since the Sabarimala judgment, and the intensity has only increased since the two women entered the temple. In international news, on January 25, students marched under the banner of the Canadian Students' Federation, the Legislative Assembly of Ontario in Toronto, protesting fund cuts in education by Doug Ford-led government. The protest was also joined by the Revolutionary Students' Movement, RSM, Fight Back and other groups. Ford's government announced a $600 million cut in student grants and $440 million cut in funds provided to universities and colleges. These include a 10% tuition cut, which actually underfunds institutions, elimination of complete coverage for low-income students, among other anti-student measures. According to protesting students, their curriculum no longer includes the customs and traditions of indigenous people in geography, history, and social studies, courses in both elementary and high school. And high schools have been forced to revert back to an outdated sex education curriculum. Most government policies relating to, for example, workers' rights and health services have been terribly affected since after the inauguration of Doug Ford as Premier of Ontario Province. In other news, Donald Trump's latest tweet repudiating global warming has stumped his Twitter followers. Trump's claim that climate change does not exist because wind chill temperatures are reaching minus 60 degrees suggests he has no understanding of the difference between climate and weather. However, the president had divorced from all logical judgment when he had claimed that his very high levels of intelligence have led him to not believe in climate change. Without commenting on this further, we're going to leave you with a few interesting replies to his tweet. Thank you for watching NewsClick. To know more about these and several other stories, visit our website www.newsclick.in. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook.